valuable gadget that captures reality without fabrication. It tells the truth. The issue of Raghoba Gaokar of Pannavaro Kavrempirla raised a controversy in the house at 0 hour, where Chief Minister Pramod Sawant said it is not true that the family had no light for 45 days. He said the line was going through forest area. Raghoba said that he had paid 30,000 rupees for 15 poles 8 years ago, and the electricity debt was asking him to get a tractor to take the poles up the hill, and that they were without power for 45 days, and that they had to light a fire in order to get light. As the controversy still shrouds the pathetic condition of Kala Academy, yet another incident marred proceedings on Sunday during a theatre show, when the curtain depicting a road scene got stuck mid-performance. However, with no other option left, the theatre director was forced to end the show with the half-stuck road scene curtain, instead of the intended scene inside the house. First-time MP from South Goa Captain Virieto Fernandez rode in Parliament on Monday, making a fervent appeal to the centre not to destroy Goa by making it a coal hub. He said there was a conspiracy to thrust projects in Goa. Listen to his first brief but powerful intervention on nationalisation of river, three linear projects and coal transportation and how it would destroy tourism. Pooja Sharma, who is the prime accused in the Assagaon house demolition case, finally appeared before the crime branch Ribandar on Monday for interrogation. Sharma had allegedly razed the Assagaon house without giving prior notice to the occupants. It has been revealed that Sharma is the wife of a high-profile diplomat and has allegedly misused her connections to acquire the land. The opposition, while disclosing that they are not opposing the national education policy, questioned the hurry of the government in implementing it without giving proper through and lack of infrastructure. While KPM MLA questioned why foreign language were excluded, Aldona MLA Carlos Alvarez Ferreira alleged a hodgepodge between aspects of NCERT and CBSE elements in Goa's NEP implementation. The Goa Assembly was adjourned at around 12:46 p.m. on Monday on parity in calling attention motions between the ruling and opposition benches. Opposition leader Yuri Alemão objected on a point of order, saying that at the back meeting it was agreed that if ruling was allowed one question, opposition would be allowed one question too, but on Monday both calling attention motions of the ruling party were listed. The Miramar footbridge, which was in a deteriorating state, has been ordered to demolish by the North Goa collector IS Sneha Gite. The rusted bridge is on the verge of collapsing. The bridge could collapse anytime, posing a life-threatening situation to the school students, tourists and commuters. The decision comes after the inspection done by the CCP Mayor Rohit Monserrat and North Goa collector IS Sneha Gite. There is fierce public opposition to the holding of Sunburn in South Goa. But should the Sunburn narrative go beyond North Goa and South Goa and not be allowed to be held in Goa at all? In this edition of Street Voices, Herald TV asked people whether the Sunburn discourse should not be only about not having the EDM in South, but not having it in any part of Goa at all. After the tragic death of teenager Aarti Gondi when a tree fell on her, the Forest Department on Monday marked trees in Panjim which are dangerous for commuters and pedestrians. The government and the Corporation of City of Panjim woke up after the death of the bitten teenager in Panjim. The recent construction work and laying of footpath and pavers by the roadside in Panjim has weakened the roots of the trees, making them victims of the gusty winds and torrential rains. In view of the tragic demise of teenager Aarti Gond, 19, from Bitim, when a tree fell on her in Panjim, deputy collectors will be instructed to immediately pass orders and cut dangerous trees in any part of Goa. The issue was raised by Chief Minister Pramod Sawant himself at 0 hour, announcing a compensation of 4 lakh rupees to next of kin of Aarti. The wall of the ruined house of Dr. Francisco Luis Gomes collapsed on early Monday morning at 6:30. The house was in a dilapidated condition due to neglect by the government. Dr. F.L. Gomes demanded freedom for India in Portuguese Parliament and was firm in his belief that Goa was part of India. Due to the collapsed wall, a house nearby suffered minor damages. The residents of nearby houses conveyed dangers due to the ruined house. The issue of use of drugs, alcohol and gambling rocked the Goa Assembly before question hour on Monday. The leader of opposition Yuri Alemão sought to raise the issue of drug abuse among police and questioned whether Goa was becoming Swayampurna in drugs among police. CM said this issue should be raised during demand for grants. Fatoda MLA Vijay Sardesai also commented outside the house that drug mafia had succeeded in infiltrating the police and narco-trafficking will not stop in Goa. The dilapidated condition of the Kharevaro fishing jetty has raised concerns amongst the fisher folks over the potential risks of the jetty falling apart. The concrete has given way and the steel rods are jutting out. The sides of the jetty where trawlers berth are worn out. Former Minister and President of All Goa Fishing Boat Owners Association, Jose Philip D. Souza, has demanded that the government grant permission to operate fishing activities from berth number 11 of MPA. Bhoma residents in Priol constituency who are up against the expansion of national highway through the middle of their village have now demanded that the legislators take up and discuss the vexatious issue during the ongoing Goa Assembly session. At a meeting held in the village yesterday, locals discussed at length at how the disastrous development project, if allowed to go ahead with, would demolish over 100 houses besides ancient temples here.